For this lesson, you need to open the sample file Human Resources 2 from your Sample Files folder. This is the workbook that you created in Lesson 7-8. The workbook contains three custom views. I can see the custom views by clicking View on the ribbon and in the Workbook Views group, Custom Views. And I can show each of the groups by selecting them and then clicking the Show button. Here's the Hours Worked Female view. Here's the HR view. And here's the Hours Worked view. Even though this workbook contains three custom views, it's not obvious to users of the workbook that this is the case. You want users to be more aware of the feature, and to make the feature easier to use by adding button controls to move between the custom views. Before adding the button controls, I need to create three macros for each of the actions that the buttons will trigger. So first of all, I'll create a macro that shows the Hours Worked view. To do that, I'll click View on the ribbon in the Macros group Macros and Record Macro. I'll call the macro Show Hours Worked view. I'll store the macro in this workbook, and for the description, I'll type display the hours worked custom view. I'll now click OK. I'll click View on the ribbon, Custom Views. I'll click on the hours worked view, and then click Show. And then I'll stop recording my macro. I think I'll do that by clicking the Stop button on the bottom status bar this time. Now I'll record my next macro, a macro that will show the Hours Worked Female view. So View tab on the ribbon, Macros, Record Macro. The name of my macro will be Show Hours Worked Female view. I'm going to store the macro in this workbook, and the description will be Show the Hours Worked Female Custom View. I'll click OK, and then I'll show the custom view by clicking View on the ribbon, Workbook Views, Custom Views, Hours Worked Female, and Show. Then I'll stop recording my macro. I think this time I'll click View tab on the ribbon, Macros, drop down, and Stop Recording. That's an alternative way to do the same thing. And now I'll record my HR view macro. View tab on the ribbon, Macros Record Macro. I'll call the macro Show HR view. No shortcut key, store it in this workbook, and the description can be Show the HR custom view. I'll click OK. Then it's View on the ribbon, Workbook Views, Custom Views. Select the HR Custom View and click the Show button. And I'll stop my macro recording by clicking the Stop button on the bottom status bar. Let's now test the three macros to make sure they work correctly. So, View tab on the ribbon, Macros, Macros. View Macros. And I'll begin with the Hours Worked Female view. I click Run to run the macro, and I can see that that macro is working perfectly. Now let's try another macro. We'll try the Show HR View macro. I click Run, and I can see that the HR view is showing correctly as well. And the final macro is the Hours Worked view. I click Run, and the Hours Worked view is also being correctly selected. So now I know that my three macros are working correctly. It's time to add those button controls and associate them with the macros. To do that, I click Developer on the ribbon, and in the Controls group, Insert, and in the Form Controls group, the Button Form Control. I click on the button and then click and drag to draw a button in the right place. And I'm now asked, which macro do you want to execute when the user clicks this button? Well, I want to execute the Hours Worked view. So I'll click on Show Hours Worked view and then click OK. And there's my first button. I'd like to put some better text on that button though, so I'll double click. I'll delete the text that's currently on the button and I'll type Hours Worked. Now I'll add my next button. That will show the Hours Worked Female custom view. Developer tab on the ribbon, Controls Insert. There's the button form control. I'll need to make this button control a little deeper because it has to accommodate two lines of text. I'm going to show the Hours Worked Female view. I click OK. And for the text, I'll remove the existing text and type Hours Worked, open brackets, female, close bracket. Now for my final button, Developer tab on the ribbon, Controls Insert. There's the button form control. I'll draw my button form control into place. And this button will show the HR view. So I click OK. Then I'll double click on button 3, remove the text that's currently in the button, and simply type HR. And I've now created my three buttons. Now let's test the buttons. First of all, I'll click the Hours Worked button. And when I do, the Hours Worked custom view is shown. Next, I'll click the Hours Worked Female button. And when I do, I'm only seeing the female employees. And finally, I'll click the HR button. And when I do, I can see all of my employees in the HR view. You've now seen how to execute macros from the ribbon, how to execute them from shape controls, and how to execute them from button controls. But there's actually two other ways in which you can run macros. The first is from special buttons on the Quick Access toolbar, and the other is by creating custom commands on the ribbon. You're going to learn how to add macro buttons to the ribbon in lesson 920. But in this lesson, I'm going to show you how to execute macros from the Quick Access toolbar. The type of macro you would execute from the Quick Access toolbar wouldn't be the type of macros that we've recorded in this lesson. They'd be macros that you recorded in the personal macro workbook. That would be of general interest for every workbook that you open. Because if you executed these macros from the Quick Access toolbar, they'd only work when this workbook was open. But let's add them anyway to see how it's done. So I'll click the Customize Quick Access toolbar button and then click More Commands. And I'm now going to add three macro buttons to the Quick Access toolbar. To do that, I select Macros from the drop-down menu. And you can see my three macros there. I'll click on Show Hours Worked Female view and then click the Add button 1, 2, 3 times to add the three macros to the Quick Access toolbar. Now you can see that they all have the same icon at the moment, which could be a little confusing, so let's give each a custom icon. I click on the Hours Worked Female view, then Modify button, and for this feature, I think I'll choose the smiley face icon. For the Hours Worked view, I'll click the Modify button again, and this time I'll have the silhouette icon, and I'll click OK. And for Show HR view, I'll click the Modify button, and I'll choose the key icon, and click OK. I'll now click OK, and you can see those three buttons on the Quick Access toolbar. And if I hover over each of the buttons, you can see the name of the associated macro. Let's test the macros now. I'll click the Hours Worked Female view and the custom views displayed. Now I'll click the Hours Worked view icon on the Quick Access toolbar. And when I do, the Hours Worked view is displayed. And finally, I'll click the Show HR view icon on the Quick Access toolbar. And the HR view is displayed. I'll now remove those buttons from the Quick Access toolbar because these macros are specific to this workbook. So I'll right-click on the smiley face and remove. The same remove and the key remove. And all that remains is to save your work. I'm going to save with the new name Human Resources 3. And of course, because this workbook now contains macros, I'll have to save as an Excel Macro Enabled Workbook. And I'm going to save to the folder above my sample files folder. I click the Save button, and you've now completed lesson 917, Run a Macro from a Button Control.